Welcome to LC Screen Talk. My name is Larry, and this is my review of Hillbilly Elegy. Hillbilly Elegy is based off of the memoir of the same name written by J.D. Vance that follows J.D.'s true story of a Yale law student that is called back home when emergency strikes. And upon his return back to his Appalachian roots, he is confronted with his family's own past and how that is affecting his own future. The film is directed by Ron Howard and written by Vanessa Taylor and the Netflix film that made lots of waves upon the trailer debuting. Now, as per usual with me, unless I particularly cannot wait for the trailer or marketing material, I generally will avoid trailers if possible. However, I saw those not great posters for the film, and I clearly saw still images of Amy Adams and Glenn Close particularly, as there was huge buzz surrounding them already just upon that initial trailer. But just based off of the appearance, I was hopeful with all of this talent involved, but admittedly, a bit nervous going into this viewing. However, I ended up loving Hillbilly Elegy. So let's go ahead and talk about the positives first. Let's go ahead and pick up with the aforementioned acting cast, because everyone in this film is truly fantastic. Amy Adams as the mother in this film is amazing. She really loses herself in this role, as does Glenn Close, who is fantastic down to the voice. It doesn't even sound like Glenn Close in this film, though it hardly even looks like her. She completely disappears into the role and then embodies this character. And both of them at first seem like they could be a bit caricature-y, whether it be through the depiction or through this hair and makeup that they're given. That quickly evaporates as they bring these humans, these actual people, to life immediately upon watching the film. They both give these really layered depictions of these people that are empathetic and understanding of who they are, where they come from, and why they have arrived at this place in their lives. Honestly, they are both just really sophisticated performances that in lesser hands would have easily fallen into that cheesy melodrama area. In addition, Gabriel Basso, who plays JD, our lead character in this film, is so good. I actually don't think I've ever seen him in anything previously. If I have, it's never been in a role of this magnitude. And he was fantastic. We have Haley Bennett and Frida Pinto in this film. Everybody across the board delivers exactly what they need to. Down to our child actors, everyone fills this film out to create an actual family in an actual story full of real life people. In addition, I think the directing is delightful. While all of Ron Howard's films have some sort of prestige to them, a good quality to them, I would say it's been a while since he's truly just nailed it in the direction department. And I think he nails it pretty well here. The flashback, this is one of those films where the flashback format works very well. It serves the story, it makes sense for what our character is going through, and helps to just fill in all of this space as we learn about who he is and what he's going through as a Yale student. It really worked well. And just the look of it, the camera work, the cinematography, everything really adds to the real world type of aspect the film is aiming for. I also think the script is very well done. Once again, the key word for the entire review is authentic. You don't feel like you're listening to characters or you're watching people on the screen. As much as the acting sets you into this real life atmosphere, the script does a great job of making it feel like people just living rather than characters set to a page. So then, what doesn't work so well when it comes to Hillbilly Elegy? Well, I think that we have so much, and there are so many characters, and the film really hinges on and rides relationships, all of these different relationships to JD particularly. And in that sense, I think it could have used a little bit longer of a runtime because we don't get the connections with everyone that I think we could have. Particularly with his girlfriend, played by Frida Pinto, we don't really get much there. There's a sequence here, a sequence there, but her character isn't really fleshed out. She isn't really given any development. Same thing with the sister, played by Hayley Bennett. We get to see some of the trauma that's happening there, some of these big life events. However, we don't really get to see the fallout with her character and how that has fully rounded her as an adult person. Then just a glimpse here, a glimpse there. And I understand this is JD's story, it's his memoir. But when we get to see a lot of that buildup as we're growing up, it would be nice to get more of that and to see how their paths differed from the same childhood on a deeper level than the clear artificial one that we do receive. And honestly, I would have liked a little bit more time with JD and his grandma. That's a connection that is really hit home and is really a driving force of the emotion within this film. But I don't know that we actually got enough time with them and their connection and their relationship. And we definitely would have benefited to get a little bit more time with those two characters, particularly together. But other than that, I think that Hillbilly Elegy is a really moving, really touching look at this man's experience and where he came from, a look back on his own past. And if I'm being honest, it actually hit home a lot more than I had anticipated, particularly the scenes in the college and just, well, being in college and not having money, not coming from a family of money, and being surrounded by all these kids who don't have to worry about paying for their next semester or getting books. In addition, that relationship with his grandmother also really hit home. And though my mother doesn't suffer with the same ailments, if you will, as his mother, I could empathize and feel myself so much in this story. So it really hit home with me. It really hit on a more personal level than I had anticipated. Not only is it a very well executed film, but it's also quite a moving film. So my recommendation is to definitely check this out as soon as it debuts on Netflix. You already have paid for your account, and this is more than a worthwhile watch. So that is my review of Hillbilly Elegy. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead, click like down below and subscribe to the channel so you are always up to date on my latest videos. Also, join in on the discussion. Are you excited to see Hillbilly Elegy? And what are your thoughts based on that trailer? Are you hoping for some Amy Adams, Glenn Close double Oscar action? Let me know either in the comment section down below, or you can hit me up on Twitter. I love you all so much for your continued support. Mwah! Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!